Hi, I am Monica Ramakrishnan. I'm a PhD student from the Department of Nutrition Science at Purdue University. I work in Dr. Saviano's lab. The topic of my thesis is the effects of A1 and A2 beta casein on symptoms of lactose intolerance. There are some definitions that we would need to know before getting into the details of the study. Lactose maldigestion is a condition in which there is usually a downregulation of lactase, otherwise known as lactase non-persistence, where lactase is the enzyme that is required to digest lactose, due to which lactose cannot be digested. Lactose maldigestion can be confirmed using a hydrogen breath test. Lactose intolerance is a condition in which digestive symptoms like abdominal pain, bloating, diarrhea, and flatulence occur on consuming dairy. Lactose digesters or maldigesters can be lactose intolerant. Approximately 65% of the people in the world are lactase non-persistent. Out of all the lactose non-persistent people, 90% of them are of East Asian descent. This condition is common in West African, Arab, Jewish, Greek, and Italian communities. In Finland, 1 out of every 60,000 newborns are affected. Major health consideration due to lactase non-persistence is low bone density. This is the nutrient composition of commercially available cow's milk. There is 3.6 grams of fat, 3.3 grams of protein, 4.6 grams of lactose, 69 calories, and 122 milligrams of calcium. Out of the 3.3 grams of protein, 2.7 grams of protein is casein. 36% of casein is beta casein. There are two types of beta casein, A1 and A2. This shows the digestion of A1 and A2 beta casein. A1 beta casein includes histidine at the 67th position in the peptide chain, whereas A2 beta casein includes prolin at this position. Digestive enzymes act on A1 beta casein and hydrolyze it, releasing an opioid peptide, beta-casomorphin 7, which is otherwise called as BCM7. The histidine residue in A1 beta casein allows cleavage to form BCM7, whereas the prolin residue in A2 beta casein prevents such cleavage and BCM7 formation. We conducted a randomized single meal feeding trial with four types of milk which varied in A1 and A2 beta casein content. 100% A2 beta casein containing milk, Jersey milk containing 25% A1 and 75% A2 beta casein, commercial milk containing 75% A1 and 25% A2 beta casein, and lactose-free milk. Lactose-free milk was a negative control. We hypothesized that a single meal of 100% A2 beta casein containing milk would be better tolerated, producing fewer GI symptoms and less maldigestion during the 6-hour study than commercial milk. We also hypothesized that Jersey milk would produce an intermediate response regarding the HPT and occurrence of GI symptoms. There were four stages in the study and they include recruitment, pre-intervention, intervention, and analysis. 853 people indicated interest in the study. Of those 853 queries, 258 completed phone screening. The other 595 did not respond to requests for phone screening. Out of the 258 who were phone screened, 111 were not eligible due to medical conditions or lack of avoidance to milk, and 5 were not eligible due to lactate use. 142 were eligible for the HPT pre-screening, but only 94 of them participated. The other 48 did not respond to attempts to schedule the test. 35 out of 94 subjects met the symptoms criteria, and 9 out of 35 withdrew from the study. 24 subjects completed the study, 2 of them are yet to complete the study. The study had to be halted due to the COVID-19 pandemic restrictions. The interested subjects regarding demographic information, current medication use, and BMI. Perceived lactose intolerant subjects with no medical issues were eligible for the initial screening test. Subjects consumed a low fiber dinner and fasted for 12 hours prior to their visit. They consumed an oral load of 0.5 grams of lactose per kg body weight on the day of their study visit. Screening involved a hydrogen breath test and a qualifying lactose challenge symptom score on consuming commercial milk containing a higher amount of A1 beta casein, a rise of 20 ppm hydrogen between any two consecutive time points of the study in the hydrogen breath test indicated lactose maldigestion. Qualifying lactose challenge symptom score includes the following three criteria: a score of 4 or 5 for a symptom, a score of 3 for 2 or more symptoms, and a score of 3 for 1 symptom at 2 time points of the study. Subjects should meet one of them to be eligible for intervention. Digesters or digesters meeting the qualifying lactose challenge symptom score were eligible for the intervention portion of the study. The subjects reported to a clinical research facility for four visits with at least 6 days in between any two consecutive visits. They consumed a low-fiber dinner and fasted for 12 hours prior to their visit. They consumed their randomized milk treatment containing 0.5 grams of lactose per kg body weight on the day of their visit. Hydrogen in breath samples and symptoms were recorded at 0, 0.5, 1, 1.5, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 hours. The breath samples of the subjects were collected and symptoms were recorded at 0, 0.5, 1, 1.5, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 hours. Power calculation indicated a sample size of 26. Pair T test was conducted and p values were calculated with a significance level of 0.05. During the 6-hour study, abdominal pain after consumption of A2 milk was significantly lower than high A1 milk. However, Jersey milk was not significantly different from high A1 milk. Regarding mean total symptom scores for bloating, flatulence, diarrhea, and fecal urgency, no significant differences were evident between those who had consumed A2 milk or Jersey milk and those who had consumed high A1 milk. Concerning the combined total symptom score for abdominal pain, bloating, flatulence, and diarrhea, subjects reported fewer GI symptoms after consumption of A2 milk compared with consumption of high A1 milk. Symptom scores following Jersey milk were not significantly different from those following consumption of high A1 milk. Jersey milk produced significantly lower hydrogen at 1.5, 2, 3, and 4 hours than commercial milk. There was no difference in hydrogen between A2 and commercial at any time point. There was a trend towards a decrease in hydrogen in A2 versus commercial, where p-value was equal to 0.08. High A2 Jersey milk produced significantly lower hydrogen as compared to commercial. Milk containing 100% A2 protein trended toward a decrease in lactose intolerance symptoms and hydrogen production, while Jersey significantly reduced hydrogen production, but the decrease in symptoms were not significant. In conclusion, changes observed with milk containing both beta casein types could be attributable to the presence of A1 beta casein.